to inform you of opportunities, opportunities to get in on companies that are about to hit big, possibly. Always risk involved when it comes to investing. We all know that, but so long and so often investment was always about having to have the prerequisite fancy suit and pocket square. No, not an Equity Guru. We're introducing you to those opportunities that are companies on the brink of something big. And we actually have a returning guest in Dr. Rahul Kushwah, who's with us now. And Doctor, you were with us, one of our first, I think you might even have been the inaugural first glance of Jody Vance with Predict Medics, PMED. But today you're with DeepSpatial AI here to tell us about it. You're still with Predict Medics, but today our conversation is about something that I'm going to need you to explain, because what is geolocation intelligence? I feel like you're about to take me on a journey on the Starship Enterprise.
Oh, I mean, absolutely. Well, first of all, thanks for having me on again. Just looking at when you were talking about Predict Medics last time, it was all about AI in the healthcare setting. Right. And today we're talking about deep spatial. So here our focus is, how do you apply AI to spatial data that everyone is sitting on, every enterprise is sitting on, and how do you actually get insights that play a vital role in making business decisions? And that is precisely what DeepSpatial is all about.
Wow. Okay. So you need to unpack that for the layperson that's going, what does that mean, doctor?
So, really what that means is that no matter what kind of business you are in, you're an online retailer, you're a physical retailer, you're a restaurant, you're running a bank, a financial institution, a lot of what's going on in your business is actually contingent upon geolocation or the spatial data that could be virtual or that could be physical. So in the end, what's happening is that you're accumulating all these geospatial data sets. Along with that, I mean, of course, you have a lot of your own business data. So using our proprietary geospatial AI intelligence and DeepSpatial, what we do is we layer a lot of this spatial data with your own business data, along with some of DeepSpatial's proprietary data sets. And then what you end up getting are some insights that have a direct impact on the bottom line. And these insights can actually really help drive business decisions.
You had me at bottom line. Because I don't know anybody in any of the businesses you mentioned or any business that we could imagine that isn't right now very concerned with what's my bottom line? How do I make my margins better, stronger? How do I fix what's broken? Identify and then fix my weaknesses. Is that what you're telling me that this AI is all about?
So we can really divide it up into four different parts. The first one is geodemographic customer profiling. It's about understanding who is really your customer, right? Where is that customer, and how do you connect with that customer? That's just the first part of the puzzle. The second part of the puzzle is, how do you manage your inventory? I mean, supply chain, as we know, they have really been disrupted because of COVID-19. Yeah. A lot of companies are bleeding millions and millions of dollars when it comes to supply chain. So how do you optimize that supply chain so you can make more money as a business, so you can save on costs? That's the second side to it. The third side is, of course, your pricing structure. When we talk about pricing for a given customer who's really your customer, what is that pricing which is going to resonate with that customer that they'll actually come out and buy the product? So you need dynamic pricing, and that's the third side to it. And the fourth side is, of course, what is that customer sentiment? What are they saying when it comes to your product? From a geodemographic profile, let's say you're selling a product north of Toronto. You wouldn't care about what people are saying about your product, let's say in a different part of USA, for instance. You would only care about what people are saying about your product in regions where you have those that distribution network. So that's the fourth part of the puzzle. And when you put it all together, when you optimize it, what you have is a direct impact on the bottom line. And that's what we are accomplishing with DeepSpatial Inc.
Okay, so for our viewers, if you want to check out, the stock symbol is DSAI, and you just went public like a week ago.
Yep. We just went public a week ago. And at the same time, when it comes to our DeepSpatial AI engine, the key is that we have already tried and validated our technology with paying customers. And some of those customers are amongst the largest beverage makers on this planet.
Really? Do we have to guess who that is?
Well, I mean, again, you just got to look for top five in the world, and the name is going to be amongst one of them.
That's right. There you go. Way to go. Way to send us on our own little journey. Okay, so let me just reiterate. Deep Spatial AI. Stock symbol is DS as in Sam AI. Dr. Rahul Kushwah is with us, the CEO here. This to me, and I'm talk show host, news talk radio host, and broadcaster. I am not an insider on anything really. But when I do interviews like this and I hear things that kind of make the top of my head pop off, it's exciting. This to me seems very exciting because you're bringing to the table intelligence that otherwise or before times would have been multi-layered consultancies and deep dives into various areas of expertise. Like you wouldn't be able to have such a general, the four pillars that you just laid down are stunning to me.
Yeah, and that's for, I guess, one of the examples I'll give you. And this is, again, from one of our clients. They were planning on opening 200 locations in a jurisdiction, and they were trying to understand that what is that one factor that is attributing the most to the success of those stores. Right. After we got a hold of their data and we used our geospatial artificial intelligence or our geospatial engine to give them insights, it turned out that every single factor that they had heard from some of the top analysts that they hired, well, guess what? It did not play a role in their success. It was a factor which no one even thought of.
Really?
So that is the actual power of artificial intelligence. And that's what we are harnessing with Deep Spatial. It's about, we're not doing, simple bad business analytics. We're not doing glorified business analytics. What we are doing is true geospatial AI-driven insights, which have an impact on the bottom line. And that's the kind of benefits that our clients have experienced. And that's why we have some very, very strong use cases that have been validated with these clients.
Dr. Kushwah, you know, what comes to mind for me is as you're speaking about the difference between analytics or analysts and AI, is there's no emotion. The AI doesn't think to tell you what you want to hear or pat you on the back or feed your ego a little bit so you'll keep coming back with more consulting or analysis fees. It's going to just say, this is who you are. So I'm fascinated by that. With every AI conversation, regardless of what it's applied to, that's the piece that is so remarkable as we move into this next phase. Now, so tell me, please. Oh, go ahead.
I mean, with this geospatial artificial intelligence engine that we have developed, the key is there are no preconceived notions when the data is fed into the system. So you're not working with any biases. Yeah. So it's all about let the data speak for itself, let the AI identify what those factors are, which actually play an impact in terms of decision-making. And that's why usually what happens is that the output that comes out of it, it's like, oh, no one even thought of it.
Crazy. I love that. Okay, so if I'm an end user, let's say I'm one of those humongous companies that you'd reference, beverage company, what sort of data am I providing you? Like, how does it work and how does it look? Is it balance sheets and workforce and inventory and you know, how complex is the pulling together of the information that is then fed into Deep Spatial AI?
So as long as the data is electronic, as long as it's tabulated, that's all we need. So again, I mean, that's where I said that every enterprise, every corporation is sitting on tons and tons of data. Right. And what we are doing is we are leveraging our AI engine to give them some very specific insights that have an impact on their bottom line. And that's why when we start to work with a client, I mean, usually we have some off-the-shelf products that we can sell them. But with certain large enterprises, what we are seeing is they're looking for something which is very customized to their needs.
Yeah.
So, I mean, for us, it's really a SaaS-based model that initially we're going to charge a fee for customization, and then there is going to be a monthly recurring revenue.
monthly recurring sort of sign up and just keep learning from the data, the real time, real use data. Deep Spatial AI, stock symbol DSAI. We're talking with Dr. Rahul Kushwah, and going public on March the 4th, what was the reaction? How was the market reacted to this?
So right now, most of the people, they don't even know about Deep Spatial AI. And
we just had one
announcement go out, I believe, 2 days ago. And we announced our board of advisors. And if you look at that board, I mean, we have Kapil Rawal, who's the director at Microsoft. We have Pulkit Trivedi. He's a director at Google. We have Robert Luciano. He was a director at Starbucks Canada. And when he was a director there, he was actually managing over 500 stores. We have Andrew Manjim. I mean, he was a director at Enbridge. And we have Saurabh Sachin. He was a director of engineering at Flipkart, which was an online retailer based out of Asia. And they were sold to Walmart for $16 billion. So again, when you look at the collective capacity of that advisory board, it's not just so much about tech, it's also about making inroads to certain strategic business development areas,
right?
Such as retail, oil and gas, energy, and the finance sector.
Stunning, though, that is quite the collection. What, way to name drop, even I know those people. That's excellent. Okay, so if somebody's watching right now and thinking, okay, I'm in, where do they go for more?
So again, I think if I was to summarize in terms of where we are with Deep Spatial, I mean, first of all, it's a very solid team, as I just said. Yeah. Along with that, we are not talking about, we are discovering the technology development process. No. We have developed technologies. These technologies have been validated with clients. Clients have paid for these technologies. So straight out of the gates, I mean, we're talking about revenue and business development. And that is our primary focus as we look forward to the rest of the year. It's all about business development, revenue growth. But at the same time, we want to leverage our geospatial engine to churn out products that go about targeting different sectors. Because, I mean, again, as I said, when it comes to geospatial data, everyone is sitting on it. Yeah. So right now, although we are focusing on certain low-hanging areas, what we are realizing is that almost any vertical you look at, they can use one of our products.
Yeah, it's limitless. There's a lot of runway here, a lot of runway leading to some great growth is what it sounds like.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So is there a location where people can reach you for more information or find out more, share the information with their family or investment group?
Absolutely. So they can check out our website. It's deepspatial.ai. At the same time, we will be sharing demos of our technology very shortly.
Okay, well, that's very good to know. I want you to come back here very shortly and give us updates along the way. This sounds very exciting. And certainly, as you said, right for the picking when it comes to the first glance, because people might be hearing about you for the very first time and someday we'll go, remember when we first heard about Deep Spatial AI? I love being a part of something like this. Thank you for doing this.
Oh, thank you. Really appreciate it.
We'll talk to you soon.
Absolutely, you bet.